All right, everyone. Thanks so much for listening to another episode of Full Buddy Cast Presents Garage Night. Garage Night brought to you by 1627 Cole Street. Cole Street Brewery, Enumclaw, Washington. Enumclaw Places, Pacific Northwest. Come on out. Hang out. Say hi. Wear your hoodie. Get 50% off. What you got?
We're doing fantasy?
Oh yeah, we're doing fantasy football right now.
Like, okay.
That's right. But we're not doing garage night. This is Full Buddy Fantasy. That's right. Here's the thing. We actually finally were able to get Corey back. And so we're gonna actually talk about the fantasy or about the Colts and all that. If you're tuning in now to listen to Corey try to defend what's going on, I'm actually kind of excited for him. We'll talk about that on garage night. But he couldn't make it for football. Jamie couldn't make it either. She became a diva. She's getting her hair done. She's getting her eyelashes done. She goes 1 week of being a podcaster, and she's full on diva right now. So you're right. This is Full Buddy Fantasy Football. We got Craig Bentley on the mic with me.
What up, everybody?
And he's from Garage Night. Again, if you wanted to hear what Corey had to say about his Colts and the demise and the rebuild and everything that's going on in the past like month, and we haven't been able to talk to Corey because I don't know where he's been. I got to find that out too. Hopefully it's not something bad. I was a little worried about that, but we'll find that. Maybe he grew another pancreas and they had to take it out again.
I haven't talked to him, so yeah, I don't know.
We have no clue. All right, so this is week 10. Week 10, most of you people that are playing fantasy football right now, probably getting close to the end of your season. Could be week 12, could be week 13. I know with 18 weeks in football land right now, they were adjusted this past year, at least in some of our leagues. So if you're on the bubble, you're probably listening to us and really paying attention to what you need to get it done. So in this episode, like most episodes, all episodes, we'll grab a player, sit a player, start a player, sit a player, grab a waiver wire, and then we'll do our locks. And I've got some gambling stuff going on that I want to talk about as well. So
perfect.
I owe you like $1 million, but we'll get there too. All right, Craig Bentley, who do you want to start this week, week 10?
This week, even though Swift is back in the lineup for the Lions, I am going with Jamal Williams a must start.
We said that last week.
But here's the deal.
What's the difference?
The difference is it's continued. Even last week, he's now continued. He has 18 carries inside the 10-yard line. That's second in the entire NFL. Only to Joe Mixon, even with Swift back.
Okay. And what's the defense looking like? I mean, they're going against, it looks like, the 26th ranked since Chicago Bears. So I think it could be a Williams and Swift running show too.
Yes.
They need to get them going in order for the passing game to open up. Jared Goff needs that. So I'm down with that. I like the Jamal Williams. Must start for me, you know, right now, my must start, there's two, they're both playing on Thursday night. So I gotta like move past that. But my pick is that DJ Moore is going to have a great night tonight. And then, the Falcons, they're giving up too many receptions to wideouts. So he's a wide receiver. So I'm just gonna do that pick real quick, just so that like people go, oh wow, he's smart. Algier, I think, is also gonna have a good game too. I feel like he's the man right now. He's the hot.
Even with Patterson back?
Patterson is Algier is like, Patterson's great. I'm not, nothing against him, but I think they know how to. They're like, once Patterson starts to kind of sway, maybe. I don't know. Okay, we'll see. All right, so my must start. You know, I picked up two players, and so I'm like, well, is that the same thing as must starting? And I think yes. Here's who you must start in your league, because two players went on the IR today for the Las Vegas Raiders. I mean, you've got Devontae Adams and you've got Josh Jacobs, and then you used to have Darren Waller. You used to have also even Hunter Renfrow thrown in the mix. With Renfrow And with Waller going on IR today, I think the play is to go with Foster Moreau. He might be able to grab him. A lot of people grab him this week, but he's, to me, a must start. He's playing decently so far, but they got to, I mean, Matt Collins is the other wide receiver. So, like, you've got to go with, at this point, I would say, the tight end. So, I'm saying Foster Moreau is your must start. I know it's like somebody that you probably don't even have or never heard of, but you have to start him. I'll do my benching. I'm benching DK Metcalf. The reason I'm benching DK Metcalf is Tyler Lockett has come alive. Geno seems to trust Tyler a little bit more. And also, I think defenses pay more attention to DK. And so, you know, that helps Lockett out. So maybe Lockett's a must start there too. But they're going to play in Germany this week. It's going to be a 6 a.m. game. In fact, the Muckleshoot Casino is going to open up a free viewing in Club Galaxy. If you want to get up early, go watch the Seahawks there. You watch Seahawks there. Maybe even bet the sports book. I'm going to talk about the sports book in a little bit because I've been betting there. And I'm not sponsored. But I'm loving it. I'm addicted. I am addicted to it right now. But anyway, I would say bench DK. I feel like, you know, you got that leg. You got the leggy, you know, jet lag and all that possibly going too. So anyway, DK, bench.
I am benching anybody that has a Commander's uniform.
Monday Night Football. By the way, congratulations. You are true, Mr. Monday Night.
Yes, that is very true.
This is the best. This is the most excited
9-0
you've ever felt.
Going to happen this Monday night.
Playing the Eagles.
So I would bench any single person. And if you had their defense, I wouldn't even think about starting them, although you shouldn't because they suck anyway. But I'd bench anybody in a Commander jersey.
Bench them.
Doesn't matter who it is.
Okay. Who's your pickup?
So here's my pickup, which this is if somebody dropped them. Because I think there was in my league, I went ahead and dropped this guy thinking, not gonna do much after he gets traded. I really think that
Chase Claypool?
No. Oh. But I really think if he's available, you go back and pick up Jeff Wilson.
Yes.
He out-touched Mozart last week, and I do think that they are possibly going to be using him as the number one back. If somebody dropped him and he's there, go pick him up.
Agreed with that. In fact, I picked up Jeff Wilson Jr. I think he might have been in the Fullbuddy Fantasy Football League. Possibly, maybe not. That is a great – that is a great pickup. I like it. I love it. In fact, I'm all about it. I'm trying to figure out where I'm starting him at. Fantasy Freaks League, maybe. I think also just grab at this point. Khalil Herbert has been picked up and dropped and picked up and dropped and picked up and dropped. I think just for injury's sake, just grab him. Just grab him. He's good. He's just, in my opinion, he's like A.J. Dillon, right? Like, he could probably score a touchdown to A.J. Dillon, by the way, super bust. Just because.
Very
super duper bust. Like, if you picked up A.J. Dillon thinking, and they project him so high every week, like, 7 points you're going to get out of this guy. Nope. You're going to get, like, maybe 1.5. That's just how it is. He's not the goal line back. Or if he is, he's not getting in. He gets, like, force field around that 1 yard line. I like that pickup, Jeff Wilson. My other one was the Moreau dude. Don't even Foster, whatever his name is. I don't know. All I know is that you gotta go with the odds, and I think the odds are good. Derek Carr needs to friggin' figure it out. That's the other thing. All right, so we're gonna do our picks of the week. Picks of the week real quick.
9-0 lock.
9-0 is your lock for sure against the Commanders.
Yep. Easy.
I'm telling you, they were chanting, but it's in Philly, right?
Yes. No,
It's in Washington?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure we played them already in Philly.
So, but the, not Tannehill, what's the guy's name? Heineke. They are chanting Heineke. Heineke. Did you hear that last game?
Oh, it's at Philly. So we already beat him in Washington. That's what it was.
So, yeah, so 9-0 for sure.
Oh, absolutely.
If it would, question. How disappointedly and like surprisingly awkwardly upset would you be if the Commanders came in there and actually beat the Eagles?
It's probably going to be a team that shouldn't beat them that does.
That does, yeah.
They're going to lose. Yeah. I mean, I'm not going to ever say this team's not going undefeated. So I'm just going to keep locking them until they do. But I would be upset on a Monday night game at home to lose this specific game. Yes.
How'd you feel about, I don't even know the guy's name.
And they ain't losing next week, so.
Who you play next week?
Oh, they're at Indy.
Is there a bet on this one at all?
We'll figure it out
as soon as he shows up, if he ever shows up. Missing wanted poster. The Titans.
Didn't do it for you.
I was so pissed. Lost that. In fact, I put the over on that one, and I was so close of getting the over. And it was looking decent, I should say. It was looking decent, but... Titans winning, too. That was looking good, too. Titans winning. Yeah, outright. I was in one of our friends' league that... I don't know if you're still in that league or not for the pick 'em, but I was the only one that he lives. He lives. He's alive. He's a real person. He's a real boy. He's dead. All right, we're doing our picks. We're almost at the end. We got to get you on the mic real quick. We're going to talk. Rewind back to Fullbuddy Friday or the garage night, but we actually have the Mr. Colt himself, fully colted out, Jeff Saturday, a.k.a. Corey Bentley. Were you surprised?
Hello.
Real quick. Were you surprised that you weren't asked to be the coach of the Indianapolis Colts?
If he's listened to this podcast, I don't know why I wouldn't be asked.
Yeah.
But I'm assuming Jim Irsay doesn't listen.
You going to take the Colts over the Raiders this week?
I always take the Colts over anybody.
Real quick, who are you starting? Deion Jackson?
Taylor practiced in full. He's going to play.
All right, cool. I grabbed Deion Jackson last week, and it was the worst decision I've ever made in my entire life. Of all decisions I've ever made. Who are you sitting?
I'm sitting most of my Colts to see what happens. I don't know how you sit Taylor, but...
Who are you grabbing?
I haven't looked at...
Are you playing fantasy football? Are you a nomad just roaming through the...
I haven't looked through my lineups this week yet.
Or last week either?
I put waiver stuff in. Who did I pick up this week for... I don't know. Pick up Fields. There you go. Everybody picked him up and everything I saw.
You say you went for it too.
No, I didn't. I have Mahomes in one league, so I didn't need him.
We're doing quick picks, okay? Quick picks, okay.
I already locked the 9-0, just so you know.
Who's your lock? Who's your real lock? Who's your real lock? It cannot be the Colts over the. It can't be the Colts or the Raiders. It cannot be.
I don't know, give me an option.
Okay.
Any NFL team playing another NFL team?
Yeah.
Like I know all the games that are playing right now.
Well. You know, I don't know.
I told you I didn't prepare or look at anything.
You kind of, I mean, I'm surprised. All right, we're going to go, fine, we'll do probably some, Seahawks, Buccaneers.
I picked Buccaneers.
You picked the Buccaneers?
Yeah.
I'm taking Bucks also.
Oh, you guys are so dumb. We got the Bills versus the Vikings. The Bills, though, could be hurting without having Josh Allen. And the line was like plus, I want to say 9.5. Might have been 7.5, and it dropped down to plus 3.5. So they're.
I'm still taking Buffalo because Keenum will. If Keenum has to play, he'll destroy the Vikings. Also,
I don't take the Bills if Allen plays.
And then Vikings if
Vikings if Allen doesn't.
All right, and you can't take again. You cannot take the Colts in the Raiders game, but I am Raiders over the Colts.
The Raiders haven't been good either.
They put two people on the IR. But literally, I mean, if Jeff Saturday is going to get a win, this is the week that he's going to get the win.
They were up by like 20 points, I think, like the last two games that they played and still lost.
The Raiders?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, I mean, they're playing the Colts, though. Sorry. The Colts have
Colts got to get a win this week. They ain't going to happen next week.
You got to bet on the Eagles also game next week.
I'll bet on it, but I ain't going to win it.
What's your guys's so all right. Well, we heard from you. We don't have any scary skellies, so let me just tell you my betting real quick.
You don't want to make a bet? You want to do an upset?
I'll do a bet. I'll do a bet right now. I'll do Raiders over Colts. $5?
Sure. Well, I still owe you $5, so I'll try to get it back.
Yeah, okay. And
you owe me 55, so what do you want to do, 5?
I want to do you and I were disagreeing on.
I'll take whoever's playing Dallas.
No.
That was an upset for me this week.
No.
You said Seahawks, he said Bucks.
Yeah, exactly. I'm going Seahawks Bucks.
For 5?
55.
For 55, you're going to take the Seahawks
over Bucks, absolutely.
All right, done.
$55.
Wow. Yes.
Not I doll just, hairs.
Yes.
Not Bucks
yes.
like a
yes.
Okay. Wow.
Cash.
Yes, 55 money dollars. I will take the Bucks.
That gives you both a reason to get up early and watch a Germany game.
Do you want to go to the
no.
at 6 a.m. and watch it? They're opening Club Galaxy. okay, so I'm in on parlays right now. So what I did was I took $80. I know not that much, right, guys? So I put $20 on a 3-leg parlay overs that I picked of the overs, 3-leg unders, and then a 7-leg over-under combination. So the 3-leg would have been like $140 on a $20 bet. You know, pretty fun, pretty good. That's like a couple weeks of betting. So, you know, I'm not trying to win. I'm not trying to retire. If I would have got the 7-leg one, it would have been $1,800. It was pretty good for a $20 bet. And then I did the Sunday Night Football, like who's, you know, does, Derrick Henry score, Travis Kelce score. I did $5, you know, kind of thing. Anyway, long story, long, addicting, fun Sunday where I'm screaming at the TV. I have never felt so alive watching the NFL football, NFL football games of the NFL football network of the NFL football players of the NFL football league.
So you're telling me gambling's addicting?
Oh my gosh. Like, fantasy football is fun. I love it. I get all right, sweet. He ripped off. I am screaming at overs and unders. You guys got to score here. I don't care who scores. Somebody score. Or the unders, like, nobody score. Aaron Rodgers throwing that. I took the under on that game. When he threw the interception in the end zone, I'm like, yes, this is great. So there were so many unders last week that hit that you go in there now, and I went in there last night to put some bets in for this weekend. And like the unders are like way lower now. Like they were thinking like last week, it was like a lot of them were floating around 45, couple 42.5, 49.5. Now there's one game with the Titans 36.5. It's like, well, I got to take the over on that, 'cause that's probably going to happen. So anyway,
is this a fantasy football episode you're recording?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay.
Sorry.
Well, I think you should just change the whole theme. And there should be Travis bets, and then you tell people what they should bet, and then we just pick games with you.
I got the end, like the end of the thing right now.
Yeah, like you tell us games, we pick them, and then you tell them what you're putting money on.
Okay, I'll go
instead of this, and we don't have to. You can still do some fantasy football players at the end too, but you can throw out bets. People can go make, because they still come out before.
Yeah,
they can go make them Sunday morning.
Well, maybe I'll add that to the garage night at the very end of the garage night, too. Well, I'll do that for this one. I'm done for this one. So I got to get my slips. I'll grab my slips and come back. But we'll just end it here. And then we'll jump into garage night.
All right.
So everyone reverse. Go listen to what I did do. And we're going to listen to this. We're doing this in reverse. Go listen. Go back if you haven't listened to Fridays. Listen to Friday's episodes. We're going to talk about bets. We're going to find out what happened to Corey. Why he showed up. Just looking like a homeless person right now. And then Corey's outfit looks like a creative skater from Tony Hawk 12.
That's Craig.
Yeah, I'm Craig.
I said Craig, right?
No.
Oh, gosh. This pumpkin beer is hitting me hard. All right, have a great week. Go
like
Seahawks.
One sip in.
Yeah, that's true. Go Seahawks.
Go Eagles.